Galacticos, the league is back and it's time now for the second leg. We have a game very important against Sporting. These are the 11 people I want to see on the pitch. Keylor Navas, we're gonna see Pepe and Varane. I think it's already time for Zidane to fix this Sergio Ramos problem. I play when I want and then I get injured and I'm out for 2 weeks. So hopefully Zidane will have him out until he's fully recovered and then he'll be back. On the right, Carvajal. On the left, Marcelo. In the midfield, Kroos, Modric. This time I'm gonna go for James. I think Zidane is wanting to give James and Isco a little bit of time to each. And I think it's time now to see James start in the game. And up top, of course, the BBC, they couldn't be doing it any better. So Bale, Cristiano, and Benzema.
Thanks a lot, Vitaly. I'm gonna go with the lineup that we saw against Depor last weekend. I wanna see Keylor Navas in goal. I really like Varane, and I know Sergio Ramos is battling injuries, so I'm gonna obviously go with Varane and Pepe in the middle. Carvajal, who played amazing this last match, and I prefer him a million times over Danilo. So Carvajal and Marcelo out wide. In the midfield, I'm gonna go with the same midfield we saw. I know I've been really critical of Cruz, but I thought he played well this last match. So Cruz and Modric, and above them, I'm gonna go with Isco. I think Isco deserves a little bit more time to get his playing confidence back and his style back. He did a good job this last weekend, so I wanna continue to see him play up there. And of course, up top, the ever dangerous BBC.
So that was our 11, guys. Before we go into the subjects we want to talk about, leave your 11 in the comments as you have been doing and we love it. And if you haven't yet, don't forget to subscribe, you know, hit there. And well, let's go with it. So the second leg is here and I have this feeling that everything is starting again. Zidane has brought this excitement back to Real Madrid. But still, we can't forget that Benitez had some problems he couldn't deal with or he couldn't fix and actually ended up causing Benitez leaving. And these are problems that haven't disappeared. They might be hidden because of the excitement, but Zidane will have to fix them. So number one, this is something a lot of you have been talking about. Will this be Bale's Real Madrid or Cristiano's Real Madrid? What's your input there,
okay,
Ashley?
Well, I have to be realistic, and as much as I don't want to say it, it needs to be either of their teams. It needs to be a United Madrid. I think, in reality, it kind of needs to be a Cristiano's Real Madrid, because when Cristiano's unhappy, he's going to play yes or yes, like there's no sitting him on the bench. So if Cristiano's playing and he's unhappy, it really affects the team in a negative way. So I think if Cristiano's happy, we can have a Cristiano Real Madrid to finish out the season and we can do well.
Yeah, it's a good point. I personally, it kind of bothers me, you know, when Cristiano is angry because it's not his team. It's kind of a bit selfish for me. I would ideally like to see nobody's team, a Real Madrid that is just a team and everybody's playing for everybody. But of course, maybe it's not possible. So I personally think it shouldn't be either Bale's Real Madrid or Cristiano's Real Madrid. It has to be just Real Madrid. Which brings us to the next point, which is one of the reasons why Cristiano hasn't been happy in the last two or three, maybe 4 months, is because he hasn't been performing well or as we expect him to perform in the key games, in important games. And this is a general problem of Real Madrid. This is one of the things that Benitez couldn't get done, is Real Madrid to play, win, and convince in important games.
Right. Real Madrid needs to show up in these important matches, and this will be the big test for Zidane. As you know, against Sporting, against the next match against Sporting, not such a strong team, so it's not really a good test to see whether or not Zidane has done what he needs to do yet. I think in the upcoming matches against Sevilla, Atleti, Barcelona, those are the matches we're really going to see is if Zidane is capable of fixing what Benitez wasn't capable of fixing.
That is true, so probably we'll have to wait until February and see if we beat Atleti and finally convince our crowd in an important game. Well, I did this, but it is an important game. Another thing that might be a problem or might become a problem if Zidane doesn't handle it well is the Isco-James thing.
Yeah.
Who would you go for?
Who would I go for? That's a tough question. I mean, I think I like them both. I think they're both very different and bring different things to the table. But I'm gonna go with James. I personally love the way James plays. Sometimes Isco, and maybe it was an issue with him not getting along with Benitez, but him this season for me hasn't really convinced me that he deserves yet that starting spot for the rest of the season. I like James, I like his work ethic, and they both are hardworking players, but Isco sometimes dribbles too much. I think he does a little bit too much with the ball. So, and I like James that he looks to find those through balls, and he's so creative. And he's cute, so.
He's cute. Personally, what I'd like to see is none of them getting that position. You know, I'd like to see Real Madrid get to the point where we don't have 11 starting players and just subs. I'd like to see a Real Madrid where we have 16 starting players and they all know they're gonna play and they are ready to do it when they have to. Because I think Isco brings a lot to the table defensively. He's more of like a pit bull. When we don't have the ball, that's something that James don't have that much. But when we do have the ball, James is more creative, is, you know, more able to generate chances and score goals. So it depends, really would depend on the game. I would like to see both of them happy and just ready to play depending on the game we have to face.
That is very ideological.
Damn. So maybe not the last thing, but the last thing we're going to talk about here is how Zidane is going to manage the team to get very, let's say, compact and together to defend.
This is the most important thing for us that Zidane could fix. We're super vulnerable defensively speaking. I think that it was something that Benitez, and maybe the players didn't believe in his system, but something that Benitez could not get the players to figure out on the field. Defensively, we are so vulnerable there, and we get so many chances almost scored against us, or scored against us as we've seen in the last couple of matches. I mean, this last match was one of the first clean sheets we've had in a long time. I think that Zidane has a big task ahead of him. It's to get the players to not just pressure when we're in our half of the field, but to also pressure and pressure organized as a team in the opponent's half of the field. I mean, that's the hard part.
What I personally would like to see, what would really make me happy as a fan, is to see all the players involved as soon as we lose the ball,
right,
and like see that look on their face when they're saying like, we don't have the ball, we need to get the ball as soon as possible. And if I saw that, I'd be so happy.
We saw a little bit of that this last match that we played, but still, Benzema and Cristiano, they're the players that up top, I mean, we saw Bale working really hard, but Cristiano and Benzema are the players that still need to buy into that pressuring up top and pressuring as the whole team's pressuring, because if they're not doing it, it's not going to work.
That is true. So Galacticos, these are some of the things that Zidane has to fix. What do you think? Do you agree with us? Have we gone finally mad? Before we give you our predictions, don't forget to leave yours in the comments below, as you always do, and we love it. I'm gonna go a little bit bold out, then I'm gonna say 6-0. You know, I got the 5-0 last week, right?
Oh,
so hopefully I'll get it this time too.
I'm gonna go way balls out.
More?
8-0.
Wow. So Ashley says 8-0, I said 6-0. Of course, Galacticos, we want to know what you think, and we'll see you after the game.